Nikola.
Hi there. Hi to all of you.
Thank you for joining us.
Long time no see.
Yes. People have been asking me, where is Nikola?
Yeah, they all ask me, you know, when will I make a new webinar?
I know, and this new webinar will be What in Astrology Gives the Richest People. It's on the 8th of July, and Nikola now will explain what it will be about. He'll give a few examples so he can get you excited.
So we will talk about the charts of very wealthy people, charts of billionaires. It is very interesting to see what gives in astrology, what gives billionaires. And what is very interesting, I had 4 clients, billionaires, and many millionaires. And if you can remember, maybe people know that billionaire from 1920, beginning of 20th century, J.P. Morgan said, what makes the difference between millionaires and billionaires? Billionaires are using astrology.
Yeah.
It's famous, saying. But what happened today, and why did he use astrology? Because his ascendant was in the sign of Aquarius. Aquarius rules with astrology, and Uranus, the ruler of his ascendant, was in his first house. The first house is somebody's action, you know, what people do when they want to be active in all possible situations.
You have a microphone. I don't hear so well.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry. So he has an ascendant in Aquarius, and the ruler of Aquarius, his ascendant, is in the first house. So he used astrology for his business, you know, and we all know that he was very rich, very influential. Okay, good. But nowadays, what happens, you know, I had 4 clients, billionaires, 2 from this region and 2 abroad. And they don't listen. I will explain you why. Wait. It changed, you know, because they feel so self-confident, you know, that they don't need advice, you know. And why they come to me? They came to me because of their family, you know, and it is also wise, you know, they want to see who of the kids will continue the job of the company, you know. And who will not, because they almost all of them have more than 2, 3, 4, 5 kids, you know. And they all know that some of, you know, one kid is for continuing the company job, others will not be able to continue because they were not born for that. You know? It is wise, you know, it is wise. And they didn't want to listen about my advice is about their job, you know, because they feel like they're gods.
Yeah.
But millionaires, they are listening very much. And they are coming not because of their families, they are coming because of job. You know? So it's very strange. You know, it's quite opposite from J.P. Morgan times. And also, listen, I have one interesting story. One billionaire, at that time when he came to me via Skype, he had $7 billion. Yes, billionaire, okay. But, you know, I told him, you must be very careful because if you make mistakes, you can lose your money and you can go bankruptcy. And he was laughing. Can you imagine when you say to somebody who has $7 billion that he might go bankruptcy and, you know, he laughed. And probably I would laugh in his place. But I told what he had in his chart, you know, he had the ruler of the 12th house to lose something in the second house, the house of money. And it is the planet Saturn, you know. So other planets in his chart gave him to be a billionaire. But Saturn is waiting, you know, his act. And he wanted to buy mines. Saturn rules with mines. So I said, no, don't buy it, you know. And he was very persistent. I will buy it. And I was saying, don't buy it. You will go bankruptcy, you know.
Yes, 12th house ruler.
12th house ruler, the 12th. And Saturn is in his chart, is in the 12th house in the sign of Taurus, you know, in bad aspects. Especially with Jupiter in Scorpio. You know. So I told him, if you do that, you will lose money and you will go bankruptcy. And he couldn't believe it, you know, and he bought it. And the last time I heard him, you know, he had only $1 billion.
And many debts.
And after that, I never heard of him. I think he was ashamed.
Wow.
You know, when you tell him, don't do that. And I told him many times, you know, and I tried to explain to him what will happen. And he didn't want to listen. You know, they think they are gods.
I totally think the same, you know. They think like But it seems like it's fated rather than it's all through their own will.
Yeah, I know. But, you know, my job is to try to warn people what might happen if they made some mistakes on what might be the mistake. So that is my job. I was just doing my job, you know. And he didn't want to listen. Okay, it was his will, you know. Okay, so, and listen, I will give a hint. There are some characteristics that billionaires must have, you know. For example, all of them must be very brave. They must not be afraid of, you know, of losing or, you know, being unsuccessful or something like that. Almost all of them are brave. And what is bravery in astrology? It is Aries, the degree of Aries. So some important planets in their charts must be at some degree of Aries. For example, very good example is Bill Gates. You know, we all know that he's one of the richest guys in the world for many years. And his ascendant is in the sign of Cancer, okay? And where is the ruler? The moon is in the 10th house, the house of success. You know, it means I want to be successful. And the moon is in the sign of Aries, you know.
Taking risks.
Brave enough, you know. And also the second billionaire, for example, John Rockefeller, the first Rockefeller. Rockefeller, how do you say it? And his ascendant was in the sign of Aries. Also means to be brave, you know, to be daring. And also, for example, Warren Buffett, you know, he made a fortune on the stock market, okay? And his ascendant is in the sign of Sagittarius, and Jupiter is at the 13th degree of Cancer, the degree of Aries.
Aries degree is the first, the 13th degree.
And 25th.
And 25th.
13th and 25th.
Okay, guys.
So you must be daring and brave, you know. You must have that in your personality if you want to be successful in life, especially if you want to be a billionaire.
What if you have the ruler of the second house cusp in Aries?
It's good, you know, it's good. But it might be, it depends on the chart. It might be good or bad, you know. It also might mean that second house is not only, second house is not only showing from what you will make money off, you know. It also, it's, to my mind, it represents what will you do with money.
Yes.
When you have money. So the whole chart will show you how you can make money, you know. But the second house is showing what will you do with money, you know. So this guy that went bankrupt, you know, as I told him, he had Saturn in the second house. And what was he doing while making money, billions, you know? He was not spending money, you know.
Holding money.
So when you use Saturn in that direction, you can have money, no problem. But what happened to him? He wanted to buy a head.
Hello.
Do you hear me?
Sorry, it's interrupted. Can you repeat again?
When he was using Saturn for keeping money, saving money, he was earning money. But what did he do? He activated the bad influence of Saturn. Saturn is the ruler of the 12th house to make mistakes and to lose. And he bought mines, you know, Saturn. And that energy went, you know, in the bad direction. So, you know, the second house is what we do with money. Not only the people think that they should look at the second house, how to make money. No.
Maybe
you can use it, yes.
Where to invest it, how to grow
yes,
it.
Yes. What you will do with money.
Yes.
For example, you know, there are lots of examples. If you have very strong eighth house, you can inherit money, you can make money by taking money from bank and make money, or you know, something like that, or you will inherit some money. And it also gives people opportunity easily to find money to invest, for investments. And eighth house is the house of stock market, not fifth. There are, you know, in some many books you can find it, it's fifth house. It's not, it's eighth house. I will explain that on webinar, why eighth house. And when you see the chart of Warren Buffett, you know, you will realize that it must be eighth house, not the fifth. Okay. What did you want to say?
What is the where, according to your observations, is the house of winning lottery? Because a lot of people call it, I want to win the lottery.
Lottery is the fifth house. Yes, it is.
Okay.
But stock market is the eighth house. I will tell you. Okay, we'll talk that about at webinar, not now, because it's a longer story.
Yeah.
Speak about it. And I will also speak about some, you know, what is what about money in astrology. For example, Taurus rules with money. Okay, so Venus represents money in general. But Scorpio, you know, the opposite side represents other people's money. So it is bank money or some loans or something. But Mercury, what does Mercury do about the money? It is the checks or credit cards. It's Mercury and Gemini. So who has Mercury in the second house, it means all the time, you know, he's spending too much money on with the credit cards. You know.
Mm-hmm.
And Jupiter is lots of money, you know, and Pluto is too much money.
Too much money. Rules,
yeah. And Saturn is to save money, to keep money, or to lose money. Neptune is also to find some hidden way to make money. You know, that's, you know, some jobs that other people can't see as a job, something like that, or to steal money, or to, you know,
or to hide
that. And also, yes, and it all depends on aspects. You know? And many of billionaires. Many of them, they have good, most of the aspects are good, you know, in their chart.
Yeah.
Most. But also, you know, some bad aspects can give you money. And I will explain it, what bad aspects. So.
And
it will be very interesting, you know, very, very interesting.
No, it's fascinating. And yes. What I love about your work is that you don't read from books. You look at people's charts and you see how it plays out in real life.
I have Mercury to learn something in the sign of Aquarius, at the degree of Aquarius. So very strong Mercury, ruler of my ascendant. So, and it is in my sixth house. So I took all the knowledge from the reality, from practice, you know, from my clients. Can say it that way. You know, because I'm listening to them. When I was starting learning astrology, I was listening to people. And then I was looking at their charts to see why this happened, or, you know. So this is the best way to learn astrology from life.
Yes.
I also realized, you know, that there are lots of bad books, you know. And it hasn't changed.
And what would it give very poor people? If you just give us an example.
Excuse me, what?
What would give very poor people, people that always have problems with money?
Listen, I'm very happy if I help them, believe me. I was, you know, I have lots of clients, you know, and I was very, very happy about one guy from London. You know, black man born in Africa, came to England, came to London. He was fixing cars, something like that. And he got married in 40s. When he was 40, he couldn't do that before. He was poor, you know. And he got a child, you know. And I was so, and I really gave him very, very good advice. Very good advice. And he was crying, you know. And I almost got cried because I was happy that I can help him, you know. But he had some good aspect in his chart. So I told him how to use that energy and what to do, you know. And he, you know, he felt that these advices were good, and I felt fantastic.
So even if we have charts that indicate some difficulties with money, just like you did in the webinar, what to do, find the best aspect.
Find the best aspect, yes. Find the best.
And webinar about that.
And also be careful with the bad aspects. Don't provoke them. Don't make them alive, you know. Run away from them. What you can do.
And you also did a webinar on remedies if you have bad aspects.
Yes. And many, you know, what is interesting, many people send me notes, you know, that remedies are working fantastic. For example, one lady, she has two daughters, and they didn't have contact about for 5 years. You know? She was very unhappy normally, you know, and they were angry at her, blah, blah. And she had, listen to this, she has the moon Saturn in the fifth house in the sign of Capricorn. So I told her what was, and it worked, you know. So I told her to put, you know, water in the fridge. You know, the moon is water, conjunction Saturn, fridge, you know, cold fridge, you know. And when she did it, I told her, you must have in your mind, I want this to help me to see my children again, you know. And she wrote me, you know, that they had a meeting in Florida, you know, 1 month ago.
Oh.
And she was so happy, she sent me pictures and photos.
Amazing.
It works.
It's like magic. So simple. But
yes, it's so simple. Yeah.
even if we have like awful chart for making money, there is a way out.
There is a way, you know. It is very rare, you know, it is very rare that I can't find solution. I have, you know, that example also, you know. And I was very unhappy because, you know, I was thinking it was my guilt, you know. But really, there are some charts you can't do anything.
Wow.
There are some charts, not all. But in many charts, you can find solution. In many charts.
What was that chart like? Like, no good aspect?
What is the problem? People should listen. You know, if I tell them do this or that, you know, they should do that. Not because I'm thinking I'm God. No. My job is to help people. You know, that's the point of astrology. Or to find a solution. So it's not because I said that. No way.
So charts that have absolutely nothing that helps them, it's maybe fated for them not to be, to experience.
Yes, but listen, there are many people are a bit lazy, you know, that is also, you know, problem. And areas, we were talking about billionaires, you know, most of them, not all of them, they have something in the sign of Aries or Aries degree activated or the ruler or something like that. It means not only to be brave, Aries means to be hardworking, you know. And remember you are a hardworking person.
I have 4 planets in Aries.
Yes, you know. Also, and you are also brave, your self-confidence. You know, why Aries represent also self-confidence? Because the sun, the planet representing our confidence, is in the sign of Aries the strongest. So that's why Aries people are, they have self-confidence, most of them, normally. It depends on each chart. And also the degree of Aries gives that. So.
Fascinating. That's great to hear.
Good for you.
I'm looking forward to learn more on that webinar.
Yeah, what is also good, you know, Aries woman is a man in the head, you know.
Yes.
But you are lucky, you look like a woman. You could be a woman. No. It's very important.
Yes.
You look like a woman and you behave like a woman. That's great. But you know, yeah. And they have a problem, you know, Aries woman, they have a problem because they can't find as strong men as they are men, you know, in their head. The man they would like must be much stronger than they.
And then they'll butt hit.
Yes. It's a problem. It's a problem for them.
That's why I found myself a Cancer husband.
Yeah,
he's the mom, takes care of the kids.
Yeah, good. Okay, so we'll speak about billionaires, but it will be very, very interesting to see how they use their energies.
And also,
listen, they must have good intuition. They must also have a vision, you know. So they are special kind of people. I met them, you know, so they are special.
So you teach us how to see intuition in the horoscope, vision, yes, and courage.
Yes.
And this combination can create big wealth.
And you know the aspects. And most of them have really very good aspects. Most of them. Not all of them. But... And I have a story. I read the story about one guy who came from the bottom, you know. And he became a millionaire. And I will talk about him also.
Oh, I'm looking forward to it. I love such stories. I love people who make it on their
very
own.
Very nice, interesting story, you know, how he used his energies in his chart.
Yes. Oh, looking forward to that. Thank you so much, Nikola. Guys, come and join us on the 8th of July. It's Sunday.
8th of July, yes.
I think it's Sunday. I'm not sure.
It is Sunday, I think.
Yes, it's Sunday, 12 o'clock Pacific time. Which is 9 o'clock Eastern time.
9 o'clock my time. So Central European time.
Yes, and it's only $29, and you learn amazing insights that you cannot find anywhere in books written on the internet, since these are observations from Nikola himself, who, as you know, is an astrology genius. So we're all looking forward to find out more about that. Thank you so much, Nikola. Yes.
Send all the best to you and your family and your kids and all listeners.
Yes, send my love to Lea and
thank you.
We'll see you soon.
Okay. Hear you on the 8th of July.
Yes, and hopefully see you in Bulgaria later this summer.
Oh, good. Bye-bye. See you. Bye-bye.